Hi, good afternoon, speak teacher Zeng. So last week we discussed on my past vlog about the difference of a regular pencil to a colored pencil. On and in that vlog na sabi ko din na mas mabilis i-erase yung regular pencil to the compared to a colored pencil. So let's just say to do a demo. Gawa lang tayong shade here using a regular pencil. Okay? Now, let's do one colored pencil here on the side. And then, let's make this the color pencil shade a little bit more lighter. And compared to the pencil that is going to be a bit more darker. So let's just add here para makita sa rehistro ng camera because it's too light. So what we have here is a shade of a pencil and a shade of color pencil. Now, last week, on my last couple of vlogs before, I said mas madali i-erase yung pencil sa colored pencil. Now, what we have here is an eraser. I just cleaned it lang. To clean pala the eraser, let's just say meron siyang dumi. So, hindi mo siya kailangan basain or sabunin. What you need to do is kumuha ka lang ng clean rug, rub it there up until mawala yung excess. Up until you could get a cleaner end nung eraser. Like this. Okay? So, what we're gonna do is a simple demo on the difference between pencil and color pencil. So let's just say the eraser. Not konti. So kapag strike mo siya, if you notice, this one mas nakikita mo pa yung color pencil compared to this one, on which mas madali matanggal yung lapis. Now, let's just say, paano kung dalawang set ng value na magkasing lalim or magkasing dilim. So, let's just say, ito yung pencil, ito yung color pencil. Okay? Para mas makita nyo na maigi. Now, ito yung eraser. Kapag ka-swipe mo ng eraser, if you notice, mas madali mong makita yung lapis na pagkaka-erase compared to sa color pencil. A better demo for that one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You would still see the color pencil. In sa traditional lapis or sa graphite. So, gaanan lang natin. Two fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, mas madali mabura yung lapis compared to a color pencil. So, para saan gayong itong art class na to for the viewers? So, let's just say you are working on a project and you're using a color pencil. Now, if you're following our art classes, even if you're not an enrolled student, before, I was giving a demo. It's a reverse method on how to do a drawing, especially kapag gusto mong gumawa ng feathers ng ibon. So let's just say, let's do a demo here. Aside muna. So, let's just say, gawa tayo ng feathers. Gusto ko ganito yung texture ng feather. And then, on the feather, meron niyang, let's just say, hindi naman lahat ng ibon, isa yung kulay ng feather. So, meron niyang dalawa or tatlong tone. Let's just say, gusto ko ng konting highlight. To highlight, yung reverse method na sinasabi is the use of eraser para mas kumapal yung balahibo ng ibon, especially kung dalawa or tatlo yung layer niya. Now, with color pencil, kapag dumilim na yung shading mo ng ganito kadilim or mas madilim pa dito like this one, and you suddenly want to create a white part around the area or kung saan meron man, kapag nag-erase ka na, medyo mas mahirap na siyang i-erase kumpara dun sa traditional na lapis. Now, it could be an advantage and it could be a disadvantage. Disadvantage is, minsan nakakatamad na trabahuin because mahirap ngang mabura. The disadvantage is, hindi ka naman kagaya sa lapis na baka mapasobra ka ng erase na wala na lahat ng ginawa mo underneath layer or under layer dun sa nauna mong procedure. So, it's a mix of mahirap alisin to not so mahirap alisin. So, when working on this one, with color pencil, you have to be careful not to darken everything first too hard and then slowly build your lighter colors or lighter shades using an eraser. Although kaya naman siyang burahin, pero kung yung iniisip mo na mas madali siyang, na kasing dali siyang burahin kagaya ng regular na lapis,